Welcome to Mastering Solutions. This projectile motion problem tells us that a pipe discharges storm water into a creek. I've drawn the picture of the problem right here, and they tell us that water flows horizontally out of the pipe at 1.5 meters per second. So we have the velocity in the x direction, and that's initial, is 1.5 meters per second. They say that the pipe is 2.5 meters above the creek. So right here is 2.5 meters. How far from the end of the pipe is the point where the stream of water meets the creek? So we need to figure out this distance here. This pattern, as we talked about in the last problem, comes up over and over and over. So pay attention, because I guarantee somehow this will be on your test. The pattern that we're going to do to solve for this is, first we need to figure out how long is the water in the air for, and then we need to figure out what is the distance that it went, obviously. That's what we're asking for. To solve for the time, we're going to look at the y component only, and we'll use the kinematic equation of y final is equal to y initial plus the initial velocity in the y direction times the time plus 1/2 the acceleration times the time squared. The initial y, we'll say that right here where the water comes out of the pipe is y equals 0. So here at the bottom of the 2.5 meters will be a negative 2.5 meters. So the y initial goes to 0. Initial velocity in the y direction is also 0. In the x direction it's not, but in the y direction it hasn't started falling yet. So we have y final is equal to 1/2 the acceleration times the time squared. We'll simplify this by multiplying both sides of the equation by the reciprocal of 1/2, which is 2, or 2 over 1. So we have 2 times y final is equal to acceleration times the time squared. Divide both sides by acceleration. So t squared is equal to 2 times y final divided by acceleration. We'll take the square root of both sides. So we have t is equal to the square root of 2 times the y final divided by acceleration. When we plug in our values, we have 2 times the y final, we set as a negative 2.5 meters, divided by the acceleration, and in the y direction, acceleration is only gravity. So we'll have a negative 9.8 meters per second squared, because gravity is pointed down in the negative y direction. We'll take the square root of both. We'll take the square root of all of that. So we have the square root of 2 times the y final is negative 2.5 divided by negative 9.8 gives us a time of 0.714 seconds. Now that we have the time, we can figure out how far it went in the x direction. We already know how far it went in the y direction. So to figure this out, we're going to use the velocity equation, which is the change in the distance over the change in time. We want to solve for the change in the distance, so we'll multiply both sides by t. So we have the change in the distance is equal to the velocity times the time. Since we already talked about at the beginning of the problem that the velocity in the x direction does not change, it will stay the exact same of 1.5 meters per second the entire time. So we have 1.5 meters per second multiplied by 0.714 seconds. The seconds will cancel, leaving us with meters. 1.5 times 0.714 gives us 1.071, or we'll round that to 1.1 meters. So the total distance that it lands from the edge of the pipe to where it hits the water is 1.1 meters.